Welcome to the Day After Today, which would be tomorrow's show. The only program that deals with the hot issues concerning climate change. And now, your hosts, Ned and Selena.
Good evening, and welcome to the Day After Today, which would be tomorrow's show. I'm Selena Stumble.
And I'm Ned Knuckles. Tonight we'll be focusing on the consequences of rising sea levels. But first, what's causing our sea levels to rise? Satellite imagery reveals all.
Increased levels of carbon dioxide in the Earth's atmosphere are trapping heat from the sun and causing the polar ice caps to melt, releasing additional water back into the oceans.
Low-level coastal areas and countless Pacific islands are now under direct threat from the rising sea levels.
We now go to the small island of Tuvalu to hear what the people of this small Pacific atoll have to say.
Ooga booga, ooga booga, ooga booga, ooga booga.
Oh, come on! Get serious!
Tourists aren't coming here anymore.
Why not?
The airport's underwater.
All this doom and gloom about climate change and rising sea levels. Why don't people look at the positives? Our swimming team is getting quite strong.
Help me!
Help me, I'm dying!
Some revealing insights there for our man in Tuvalu.
If these low-lying islands and coastal areas are flooded by the rising water, there will be millions of refugees fleeing these places and looking for a new place to settle. The sudden influx of millions of refugees will place a tremendous economic and social strain on the other countries. What are scientists trying to do to avert this problem? Nuclear physicist Professor Scrubalungshung joins us via satellite. Professor, what's driving this increase in sea level?
Ah, yeah, the increased CO2 emissions, trapping thermal activity and causing an acceleration in the polar ice caps. Yeah, it leads to an increase in ocean height by 2 meters by the year 2012.
What does this mean for the low-lying islands of the Pacific region?
Oh, they're finished. Kaput. Finito. Hasta la vista, baby.
You claim you have the solution to this melting ice cap problem?
Oh, yeah, yeah. The solution is quite simple. We refreeze the ice caps using a chain of nuclear reactors, strategically built around the perimeter of the North and South Polar regions.
Wouldn't that create a lot of heat and toxic radioactive waste?
Insignificant problems to be overcome by scientists in the future. But realistically, a short-term solution would be to simply trap the nuclear waste in blocks of frozen ice and bury them deep underground for a couple of million years.
Thank you, Professor Scrubalungshung.
You're welcome.
Carbon dioxide, greenhouse gas culprit. There's another gas starting to emerge as an equally damaging greenhouse gas, methane. What exactly is methane? Where does it come down? We talked to a local bean farmer whose industry may be affected by future bans on a product his family has grown for generations.
I've had my beans scientifically analysed. My findings indicate that in a tube over 7 days there are no discernible emissions of methane gas. Look at them. They're small, delicious, and full of protein. In fact, my family has been eating beans for generations. There is absolutely no scientific evidence to support the claim that beans otherwise produce significant amounts of gas, greenhouse or otherwise.
Whew, that's a relief.
Yes, those kids sure love baked beans. Now, to wrap up, let's hear from our weatherman, season weather waster, for a forecast on the local tides.
Thank you, Ned and Selena. As you can see from our global satellite photograph, sea levels have risen 2% over the last 12 months. This extra water has come from the polar ice caps, which have been slowly melting because of the increased air temperature of our planet. As we saw earlier in the program, these rising ocean levels are slowly starting to inundate low-lying Pacific islands, and the sea levels will continue to rise.
Gee, season, that sounds serious. Any chance it will affect us here in Australia?
There is insufficient data available at the present time on the impact of rising sea levels on Australia's coastline.
Whew, that's a relief.
So it sounds like Australia might not suffer any ill effects from rising ocean levels for some time then.
That's right. Not in the foreseeable future, at least.